Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I said, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It is my prayer that this month we set you on a new altitude. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. That this new month will bring you to another dimension of life. Please, you may be seated. I welcome each and every one of us to this glorious service. It will birth a new beginning in your life. It will usher you to another dimension of life in the name of Jesus Christ. Hebrews chapter 4. And verse number 1. Hebrews chapter 4 and verse number 1. It says, let us therefore fear lest a promise being left us of entering into his rest, any of you should seem come short of it. For unto us was the gospel preached, all of us, as well as unto them. But the word preached did not profit them, not that the word was not powerful, but there was expected action from the one that received the word, not being mixed with faith in them that had it. Now, if you look at your Bible, the Bible talk about faith. It says faith without work. So faith is not memorization of scripture. Every word of faith will demand an action from you. Every word of faith will demand a corresponding action from us. It said the word was not mixed with faith in them that had it. That means they had the word. They claimed they believe it, but the faith or the believing was not complete. Everything you believe that lead you to no action is not a complete belief. You heard what he said? He said, we have belief, therefore we have spoken. We have belief, therefore we have spoken. We have belief, therefore we have spoken. Amen. If you believe, according to Corinthians, if you believe, there should be an utterance along or expressing what you believe. Are you on that system, please? If you believe, there should be an utterance along the line of what you purported to have believed. If you believe there is God, worship him. If you believe there is what? There is God. What do? Worship him. If you believe there is God, reference him. If you believe there is God, obey his word. You see how it goes? Whatever you claim you believe, there must be a corresponding action to justify what you claim to believe. So believing demand that we express it in our action. When you believe, there should be a corresponding action. Give us Corinthians, if you believe. It's 1 Corinthians chapter 4. Is your system hanging? Verse 13 says, then check 2 Corinthians 4:13. It said, we having the same spirit. Are you hearing that? We having the same spirit of faith. The same spirit of faith. According as it is written, I believed, and therefore have I spoken. We also believe, and therefore speak. Anything you claim you believe that does not reflect your action and your utterance, it will never bear fruit. Remember what James said? He said, faith without work is what? Is dead. Faith without works is dead. Faith without work is dead. And I'm coming to you this evening in this particular service to let you know, when the Bible said the path of a just man is as a shining light, shining brighter and brighter unto the perfect day, God simply forbid the realm of stagnation in the life of a believer. Now, if you look at James chapter 2, he was talking about faith. I will start reading from verse 18. Verse number 18. It says, yea, a man may say, thou hast faith. Thou hast faith. They see you going to church. They say, you have faith. And I have works. He says, show me thy faith without thy work, I will show thee my faith by my works. You see that? He said, thou believest that there is one God. He said, thou doest well. And he said, well, you have not done something special, because even the devil also believe and tremble. The devil also believe and what? And tremble. But what is the difference between a believer? What is expected to be the difference between a believer and non-believer? Works. 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 What you do with what you are hearing. Works. Works. He said, but will thou know, O vain man? Vain man. Man without a result. That faith without work is dead. I'm taking you slowly, slowly. Just come along. Faith without work is what? Is dead. Now that brings us to simple affirmation or confirmation why many believers, their life is void of the life that is in Christ Jesus. The faith they have is a dead faith. So they don't have what it takes to live. Because the just shall live by his faith. He repeated 4 times. The just shall live by what? By his faith. Now, what we purported to be faith, that we go to church, we know scripture. The Bible says, if it lack the backing of 2 things, speaking the word of faith and doing the work of faith, is a dead faith. So it becomes practically impossible for a believer to be alive. What is the life of a believer? What is expected life of a believer? Several scriptures point out to several dimensions of the life that is expected of a believer. Romans chapter 8 verse 19. He said the earnest creature are waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. You see that? That is a, you are expected to be manifesting. To be manifesting. You know what it means to manifest? To show many-sided of a thing. To make to see. It's like manifold. Many-sided. You are supposed to be manifesting it. Now, if you go to Mark chapter 16 and from verse 17. Mark 16 and from verse number 17. He said, and these signs shall follow them that believe. These signs, you see, we are back to believe. And these signs shall follow them that believe. These signs shall follow them that believe. So when you are a believer, there should be a signs. Can I hear your louder amen? Amen. There should be what? A sign. Say this sign shall follow them that believe. And the sign is talking about does not follow those who don't believe. You see that? This sign shall follow them that believe. In my name they shall cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. And the next verse 19 says, they shall take up serpent, and if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and the sick shall recover. You see what you see? You see the sign? The life designated for a believer. I see you living this kind of life. Amen. Let me hear your louder amen. Amen. Let me hear your louder amen. Amen. You can't have an understanding and not have a life. Even in this service we are in, if you understand the scripture and it make meaning to you, it will spark action. Such action is you write. Such action is you nod your head. Such action is you exclaim in spiritual language, hallelujah, amen, because it makes meaning to you. Amen. 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 It makes meaning to you. Why? Let me show you where I'm going. Ezekiel chapter 2 verse 2. Ezekiel chapter 2 and verse number 2. You know, we are asked this month to go and impact our what? Our environment, our surrounding, impacting the lives of people around you. Now, Ezekiel chapter 2, let me start from reading from verse 1. He said, and he said unto me, son of man, stand upon thy feet, and I will speak unto thee. You see the command? Stand upon thy feet. And I will do what? And I will speak unto thee. Verse 2. And the Spirit enter into me when he spake unto me. There was a way I was before his word. But when he spoke, the Spirit entered into me. And what does the Spirit do? Did? And set me upon my feet. And I heard him that spake unto me. The stagnation you see in the body of Christ can be as a result of the following, therefore. One, you know, he said, how will they hear except someone is sent to preach? And he said, how will they believe except someone is sent to speak to them? The stagnation that you see around your life is not as a result of the strength of the opposition. It's as a result of two things. One, or three things. One, you heard, but you don't believe. Or you believe, but your belief was not complete. A belief system must make up of two or three things. Number one, an action. Number two, a language. Number one, an action. Number two, a language. A language. And then number three, those combination emit supernatural life now. He said, as he spoke with me, the Spirit entered into me and set me upon my feet. So every word of faith is to change your position. Every word of faith forbids you to remain on the same position. That's why the Bible says the just shall live by his faith. The depth of your inner conviction that is wrapped up with your action, both walk and spoken, create a new life. Both action and spoken create what? A new life. So you are forbid to be stagnated. Can I hear your louder amen? Amen. That's why the Bible says in the book of Daniel, it said, they that do know their God, they shall be strong and they shall do exploit. I see a new day for you. Amen. Can I hear your louder amen? Amen? So we are on the subject of imparting your what? Your surrounding. So the reason why I take you through, I don't know how you have been fearing in that activity. I made up my mind since the day it started. There is no day I don't impact one person's life. I just make up my mind. It doesn't matter how many times you come to church. Your life will not change by coming. Your life begins to change by doing. You see, when God's word is preached and you believe, that means you are speaking it, you are acting on it. As God is moving around, he begins to establish those acts in your heart. That's where Mark finished. He said, and the Lord went with them, confirming. Where was he confirming it? He was confirming it on the life of those who believe it complete. And the complete belief now, they believe, they spoke, and they did it. He was confirming it with what? With signs and wonder. But look at where the journey began. He said, these signs shall follow you. But you have a role to play for the sign to happen. So it will take your cooperation and God's cooperation for you to have a new life. I pray for everyone, new life amen. Must emerge this month. Can I hear your resounding amen? Amen? Your new life must emerge in the name of Jesus Christ. Last week in Nairobi, a lady was testifying. It was one of our choir girl or lady. Since they don't want to be called girls. When you call them girl, they get angry. And when you call them woman, they say they are not woman. So one of our female, she was sharing her testimony. I was in the church there and I ministered that day. I will never forget, Imi was around. And I share on touching life of people around you. I just share. But as she was coming from home, she has just made a new decision to start selling things. And it started with small things like sweet, chocolate, and goody-goody. I think I mentioned it here. So she just started. So now when I've shared that and I was telling people that, look, the problem of many believers is that they think life is to be taken from somewhere. That's why I see people blame people. They say that person didn't help me because they believe their help is in the hand of that person. Life is to be built. That's why Paul said, I commend you to God and to the word of his grace, which is able to build you up. So, after the sharing, he said, while I was ministering, it just dawned on him that today's message is for him. He has sweet here. So, the best thing is to start sharing with people. Because I tell them, life begins with where you are. How far it will go will be determined by the instruction you are working with. But your life, Abraham was told, from where you are. And then we were seated in the office. She came in and gave me goody-goody. You know, I've not seen it for 30 years. In fact, I don't know you have it here. You know, some of you are pretending like you don't know it. And that is when you started stealing your mother's money. That's where you all began. When you pick the five shillings, you go to buy goody-goody. So she came and gave me, I think, maybe two or three. And then she went to Pastor Emmy and gave. And I think the following day, I don't know how it happened, Mama was also around. We're there. She still did the same. She was sharing her testimony. That from that day, her life just changed. Her life did what? Change. If you remain where you are, waiting for everyone to come and take you to where you will go, you will be wasted there. Here is a miracle. He said, from there, he was wondering, okay, now that I'm sharing this thing and I'm also selling, I think I should start looking for a shop. He said, but then if he's to look for a shop, he should think of places like Rongai. But from nowhere, she shared last Sunday, she had her shop right in CBD. Amen. God opened door for her. Amen. Look, any word you despise, permanent you where you are. Every word of God you hear and despise, permanent you where you are. And every word you obey, change your position. That's why I say, if you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the fruit of the land. There is no fruit your life need that is not available. There is no fruit that your life is in need of that is not available. The reason why you have not laid hold on it is that to every fruit there is instruction. To every fruit of God there is an instruction. Harvestable by our obedience. I repeat those statements. There is no fruit. There is no fruit that your life has a need of that is not available with God. But every fruit of God is power by an instruction, a divine instruction. And that fruit is harvestable by what? By your obedience. I don't know whether I should give you this testimony. Now I have so many. So I weigh you now to tell you the one to share with you. When Mama was going home, automatically, when you are out of away, those of you are in Kenya here, you don't have a problem with your family. You can easily send 500. Is that not correct? But you can't send 500 to Nigeria. So when you see them facing home like that, it's expensive because everybody believes this nation, as long as outside your country, all the tree there give dollar as a fruit, including the one in your compound. So they don't know why you don't plug enough. But the most important thing, she was going for a meeting and also to be with the Kneslabi, since we didn't make it during the burial, to spend some time with her sister. So all the money in this world is needed. Amen. All the money in this world is what? Is needed. So there was one money which was meant for my mentor. It's my tithe that I've gathered. Some from 2020, right? I have an account for him here where I keep the money till I see a reliable person and then it's delivered to him. You know, I've worked around leadership. You can send some money and it will never be where you send it to. The bigger they are, the more it disappears. Praise God. I said, praise God. So just like it's your responsibility to get your tithe here, that is how it's my responsibility to get my tithe to where it's needed. And I just collect the money and I told Mama, we don't have much money for your trip, but this one must touch the hand of my mentor. It must reach where it's going. Now, I have a thousand reasons not to do it. A thousand reasons not to do it. I will say I will do it later. So she went. And then she gave the money. And amazingly, when they were there, my mentor called me and then we chat. And he said, oh, your wife is here. Come and rescue me from their hand. And we crack a joke. He said, he's here with her sister. I don't know how we're doing their midst. And then we just crack jokes. And then everybody forget. But as he was leaving, he said, I've also received your seed. I command the blessing of God to start flowing now. It looked like a simple prayer. He said several words. Before that evening, I think the morning I was calling you, I said something has happened in the realm of the spirit. Where you are is not barren. Where the business you are doing is not barren. It is the heaven over you that is closed. And it was not closed because God hates you. He closed it and gave you the key in his word. Did you understand? He closed the heaven. He didn't give it to your enemy. He gave it to you. He didn't give it to the enemy. He didn't give it to the devil. Are you understanding what I'm saying? And that was how I zoom into another level of life. And completely another. In fact, I had to call Mama. I said, wow. See what obedience does. And it has not ceased. Up till last Sunday, he's still intact. And I'm sure he's intact now. But you see, we always have our human reason. That's why God warned you ahead of time. He said, come and let us reason. I know you have your own reason, but let's harmonize the reason. Life is not hard. Life has been made simple for us by God. I told them in Nairobi, I don't know whether I mentioned it here. The day you gave your life to Christ, the badge on your neck was removed. The badge on your neck was labor and eat. You have to sweat. That was the label that was on us. And that was life, what life was giving us. But at salvation, that badge was removed. Amen. And a new badge was placed on you, amen, which is called the badge of his favor. Amen. The badge of what? Of his favor. That's why he said, I will bless the righteous. Listen to this. I will bless the righteous. And with favor will I compass him as with a shield. Where you are is not hard. Amen. Stop making people believe that where you are is hard. Somebody was sharing testimony with me in the morning. He said, I did this, I did this. The Lord said this, but be a week to the time her own. By the time her own will come to pass, the law was changed. It is not coincidence. You know, something happened to you, think it's coincidence. No, why you? Praise God. I pray for every one of you that you will obey the theme of this month and begin to touch life. I don't know. I've not been counting how many clothes I've given out. It's a purposeful thing. As long as you sit on destruction, challenges of life will sit on your head. As long as you are seated with divine instruction, the challenges of life will also sit on you. Let us run with divine instruction. Let us run with divine instruction. And you know, your home may not be clothed. Do you know all of you have free thing you can give? The gospel. It's a free thing. Just go and tell someone, I am so person. This is my life in the past. I was a prostitute. This is what I used to do. I cannot do without prostituting. But now, I gave my life to Christ and my life has changed. That's all. You don't know what he's also doing that he's battling with. You don't know. Praise God. Tell your neighbor you have something to impart your surrounding. If you are willing and obedient, there is something to impart your neighbor with. Hallelujah. I say hallelujah. Where you are, I repeat, I don't know who that this word is for. Where you are is not barren. Amen. It is not the work of your hand. Amen. Because in every field of endeavor, there are catalogs of successful people and there are also catalogs of failures. So it's not your profession. It is the heaven over you. The heaven over you. So what God did, he placed a badge of his favor on your neck and then give you the key to open where, whatever you want. You remember in Matthew chapter 16 and verse 18, he said, thou art Peter, and what? Upon this will I build, upon this rock will I build my church, and the gate of hell shall not prevail. And you know what he said next? He said, and I say unto thee, thou art Peter, and upon this rock will I build my church, and the gates, not one, the gates. You think his situation militating over you is not true. It's not true. You think it's your mountain that is stronger than you. It is not true. It's not true. It's not your mountain that is stronger than you. That's why I say the greatest enemy of a man is a member of his household. What is against you is your character towards the world. What is militating against you is your character, your attitude towards the world. It's not the gate of hell. He said the gate of hell will attempt, but it shall not prevail. And what did he say? And thou shalt lose, and whatsoever thou shalt lose on the earth shall be loose in heaven. Is that there? I've jumped to verse 19. Because he have already said, and I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom. The keys of the kingdom. The day you are, listen to me, the day you are born again, the master box of all the keys you were given. You know, in an office, they lock all the offices and they put it in one place. That's why he said in Mark chapter 4 verse 11, unto you it is given to understand the mystery of the kingdom. So you begin to use the mystery to unlock each door according to your desire. As you leave this service today, I see a new beginning for you. I see you emerging a champion to your generation. That's why I started, before I travel, I started on the subject, born as a positive influencer, part one. Now I'm continuing on part two. Born as a positive influencer. You are not a liability to your generation. You are not a liability to your generation. You are not a problem. You are a solution. You are not. You are not finished. Come on, tell your neighbor, you are not finished. You have a fresh beginning on daily basis. You are not a loser, no matter what happened yesterday. That's why he makes his word new every morning. Every morning. Tell yourself, I'm a positive influencer. Shout it louder. Matthew chapter 1 and verse 20 to 23. We read it the last time. They are our anchor scripture for this one. Matthew chapter 1 verse 20. I will read on to 22. He said, but while he thought on this thing, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary, thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is what? Is of the Holy Ghost. And look at it. That which is conceived in her is of what? Now, Jesus was not yet born, but his future was already ascertained. I wish you can catch it. Do you understand that? Now, and he shall bring forth, and she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall put his people in problem. For he shall be problem in the hand of his people. Please change your mentality. Change your mentality. You are not a liability. You are not to be a concern on the earth. Come on. Come on. You are not. Stop looking like one. Stop thinking like one. Stop talking like one. And thou shalt call his name Jesus. Why? For he shall save his people from their sin. He was an a positive influencer to his generation. A positive influencer. A positive influencer to his generation. And you know, he came with that mentality. You know why some people may not have done anything this month? They've never seen themselves as a positive influencer to their generation. That's why they have not done anything. That's why they have not done anything. Somebody met me, so I think the cost of this one, I said, I have this problem. How much it is? 6,000. 6,000? Please, take 5,000. Finish your problem. I know what I'm doing. When you are looking for mango when it is not in season, you will suffer. There is nothing as good as operating in the right season. This is a season to touch the life of your neighbor so that you can provoke the touch of God on your life. When God touch you, problems smoke out. You remember what he did unto the mountain? At a touch of him, the mountain smoke out. They were out. It's a new day for you. Are you following? I say, are you following? Now, when Jesus came, he knew. He knew his purpose. And I'll be showing you the impact of knowing your purpose and adhere to your purpose or run in pursuit of your purpose. Now, you will discover the Bible didn't say, and it shall be wealthy. It didn't say so. It said, we save what? For he shall save his people from their sins. And you, of course, when you save someone from a sin, you must have saved him from the consequence of his sins. The consequence of his sin was affliction. The consequence of sin were lacks and want. So he says, shall save his people. So Jesus came to save us from sin and the consequence of sin. He came to impact our life positively. You remember what the Bible says, for you know the grace that was upon him, that even though he was rich, he became poor, so that we might be rich because of his poverty. He exchanged his position. Praise the Lord. So he was a positive influencer. He was a positive influencer. He was a positive influencer. Praise God. I said, praise God. And I want to tell you ahead of where I'm going, that is a noble calling that is upon your life and upon my life. You are also called to be a positive influencer. Are you there? Now, let's go to Acts chapter 10, verse 38. Acts chapter 10 and verse 38. Look at it. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with power. Do you know the same is upon you? The only difference between you and Jesus, you have not acknowledged that you are a what? A positive influencer. That's the only difference. As for the anointing of the Holy Ghost, you have been baptized with the Holy Ghost. He said, you shall receive when the Holy Ghost is come upon you, you shall receive what? Power. What will you be doing with that power? And begin to influence your Jerusalem, your Judea, your Samaria, and your uttermost part of the earth. So when Jesus was anointed the same way we received the Holy Ghost, what did he do? Who went about? He knew there is purpose on earth. Who went about? Nobody pushed him out. Not even like you now, I'm pushing you. No preacher preached to him. He went about. What was he doing? Doing good and healing all that were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. So God is with you to the level you are ready to influence your surrounding. And you all know we need the presence of God. Are you still there? 1 John chapter 3 verse 8. 1 John chapter 3 verse 8. You know, many of you came by Matatu. Right? And many of you are going with your car. At no time is a man lack what to impart his generation with. Those of you came with Matatu, there's somebody sitting to you from here to Mikindani. What were you doing with him? You have all the opportunity to influence him or influence her. Those of you living here, you have all opportunity to say, hey, how are you? Where are you dropping? I'm going towards VOK. I'm going towards down there. Can I drop you on the road? Don't wait till people beg lift for you. It's an abuse of your wealth. You are misusing that privilege. Don't wait. Don't wait. I don't know whether any one of you is available among you here. I'll pick people here from here to be okay. And I will drop them and turn back. I've dropped you many times. It's an abuse. When you wait for people to beg, that means God's wealth is in a wrong hand. Hello. God's world is what? It's in our wrong hand. Because you know what he said to Abraham? And you are a seed of Abraham. I will bless you and make your name great. And out of you shall all the family of the earth be blessed. You are extension of my nature. You are what? You are, as a believer, you are an extension of God on earth, extension of his nature on earth. That's why he says, as I am in heaven, so you are on earth. It's not only for defense and for prosperity, also in behavior. But that's the message you preach today in the church. The whole church will go quiet. But when they say you shall buy a car, hey man, Lamborghini. You know why you have not seen the Lamborghini? You have not been Lambo loving. When you are Lambo loving, you begin to see Lamborghini. I'm not preaching. You know, sometimes I laugh at people. You can get angry and not talk to me. It won't change my life. You can get angry and withdraw your help from me. It will change my life. Because there was what I was doing before I warned you. If you have not taken the procedure, you can't take the product. If you have not taken what? The process, you have not taken any product. If you can't stop the process, you know, sometimes I laugh. People, God is using them mightily in church, and they are able to do 1, 2, 3 for the church, and then they get angry and withdraw their tithe. You are such a baby. You are such a baby. And they'll be expecting evil to happen there. No evil will happen. It was never begin with your effort. So the sustenance of that work is not going to be by your effort. It's a faithful is he who have called you. Rather, you are the one that is a loser. Because you lack opportunity. You lack valid opportunity. It is not every ministry that brings return. Not every land is productive to a particular seed. And you remember, you are the seed that the Lord has blessed. So there is where you are fruitful. Can you imagine getting angry in Meru and carry your Mira and say, I'm very angry. I have 15 acres in Voi. They will harvest it as Michicha. It won't do. You can imagine me getting angry and say, now I'm not going to do ministry again. No, God has nothing to lose. He will replace me. But whatever I'm going to do, I'm in trouble. Because that is not where I'm meant to bear fruit. Praise God. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying here? Is somebody hearing what we are saying? So don't let people beg you for help when it's within your power. You are breaking the law of blessing. God said, I will bless you. I will make your name great. If you are Christ, you are Abraham's seed. The blessing does not stop with Abraham. It is extended to us that are in Christ Jesus. And what did he say to Abraham? As I bless you, here is your covenant responsibility. Out of you shall all the family of the earth be blessed. You know why I put the family of the earth? Because you will concentrate on your family. The family of the earth. So Jesus knew. If you look at the life of Jesus, he was not focusing on his family. He was not what? He was not focusing on his family. There were brothers among the disciples. He was so heavenly minded. In fact, they called Mary's mother. He said, no, behold your mother. In fact, he told the mother, woman, I vowed many years ago before I met virtually all of you, I think around 1996, I vow there will never be a day what I give to God will be equal to what I give my mother. And I had only her. Mama is saying home because he knew. There will never be a day what I give to God will be the same with what I give. My mother must be lesser. Because I read Hebrew, the father of the spirit. So there are two fathers. You know, we invest in our family and then we are knocking heaven for our return. It's like saving in a different bank and writing check to another bank. That's why he warned you, seek ye first the kingdom of God. Because that is what guarantees your welfare in all areas of life. I pray that you will go and touch your neighbor. Somebody say, why are we surrounding? That's what the Bible says. God says, if you claim you love me and you don't love your neighbor, how great is this your love? How great is this your love? That's why I said, when I came to the prison, you didn't minister to me. I came here hungry. And they said, Master, when were you hungry? He said, well, the poor you saw and neglect. Today the body of Christ have left all these things. They have left all this in. And I will be showing you that is the reason why we are laboring so hard to meet end. Because we are not sowing seed. What we want from God, we are not making it happen for his people that are around us. I think towards the beginning of this beginning of this month, I in the night God woke me up. I didn't know. Now I'm knowing because of what I'm seeing in Facebook. He said, now begin to pray for everyone that has been kidnapped. And you know, kidnapping is something else in Nigeria. Begin to intercede for them. And I open my mouth. I say, Lord, every hideout, let them be discovered. Everywhere there are criminals. And God said to me, imagine if your children are in that situation. For a family to get a child, they say they pay $150 million. After about three or four of them have been killed. We are no longer sensitive to our surrounding. We are no longer sensitive to our surrounding. As long we are okay, we wear good clothes, we wear... But don't you know sinners are doing this thing even better than you? You are here, your weaver you are buying at 3,000, 1,005, highest maybe 15. There are people buying 500. You reach here. But does that make them godly? So we are not called to consume. We are called to impact. Let us not be carried away by availability of food. The food is to sustain us. While we are doing our main assignment, you say the kingdom of God is not in what? It's not in bread and butter. But in the demonstration of the power of God. In the demonstration, we are to show our world the power of God. Not really somebody falling down. No. You know, when we talk about power, people you might say, if I lay hand, nobody will fall. Mm-mm. The power of God includes meeting the need of the needy. The power. Why will you be meeting the need of somebody? It's because he said, for no man does anything. For no man does what? Anything. For it is God that worketh in you both to will and to do his good pleasure. Do you know there are rich people who cannot give you 500 shillings? Very rich. But do you know at your level, you give 500, you are even wishing you have 1.5. It is God that is at work, and we need to show it to our generation. Can I hear your resounding amen? Can I hear your resounding amen? I was telling somebody in my office today, my nature. He was angry with something, and I was telling her my nature. If you are around me, I will finish my money and finish your money. You see, it's nodding. Eric is nodding. He said, I will finish my money and I will finish your own. He said, yes, sir. So I'm sure many of them, when they are coming to my office, they empty their money inside their car before they reach me. I'm telling you, that's how I am. I will finish my, and I'm not finishing it on buying food for me. I'm finishing it on somebody who have a need. So there I was remembering that my son, Papa D, I'm owing 50-something thousand. Because sometimes I will call him, I'm supposed to send him money and I don't have in my pocket ready. And I say, Papa D, do you have money there? Yes. Send 2,000 to Isaac. Send 2,000 to Erofi. Send money to all of them. You are not big by what you carry in your bank. You are big by life you touch. That's my nature. One day, Mama was seated and was happy in her office. And I saw Mrs. Rotimi was like this on the road. She was pregnant. And you know, when women are pregnant, I think they go to school of shooting their stomach. And I saw, I said, so this woman, as she is, she's still waiting for a matatu. Just between Omoya, just a few minutes, I just reached office. I said, mine, this is your car. It's no longer yours. I said, why? I said, I saw a pastor's wife on the road and was standing. We have two cars. They don't have any. So we are giving this car out. Thank God for good wives. Some will have plead the blood until there will be no blood in heaven. It's okay. And then we give them. Now, the man is in Nigeria today. He's driving a heavy jeep. You better help people when they need it. Their condition will not remain the same. They may even go higher than you. Look at your neighbor and say, this is my round head. Tell him powerfully, this is my round head that you see. And you are looking down on it. Especially the hairstyle that is on it. It's a head that is going to very far places. So treat this head with gentility. When I was in redemption camp, the kind of honor they gave me is more than a car. Every needy person around you is a stepping stone to your next placement. Don't despise them. He said the poor you will always have around you. The poor here does not mean somebody who lacks food. We all have a need. There is an area of my life that I'm poor. There is an area of my life. The reason why money runs away from many people, they don't know its purpose. Money live in heaven. So your money must support kingdom agenda. Give us that scripture in Proverbs. It's a word, fly to heaven. So let your resources bear where money is going. It will return back to you. It will what? It will return back to you. You have 5 suits in the house. The problem many of you have small body. I don't know why. It's only people like Brother Malumbi that has body and hores. That's the problem. Many of you have very small body. And you wear small shoes. So sometimes I have to look around. Before I see who to give. You are not great by what you possess. You are great by what you despise. say he has dispersed. You know why we call God great God? He gave his only begotten son. Not to people who worth it. Don't even help someone in an anticipation of return, because you'll be disappointed. The people you help in our days are the ones that turn to bite you most. Do it as unto the law. Do it what? As unto the law. I pray for every one of you for a fresh baptism of understanding of your purpose. Let me hear your louder amen. Let me hear your louder amen. 1 John. John chapter 20 verse 21. Some people are looking for 1 John chapter 20. Are you there? John 20 and verse number 20. 21. Or let's start from 21. Sorry, 20. From 20. And when he has so said, he showed unto them his hand and his side. Then were the disciples glad when they saw the Lord. May from now onward, when your neighbors see you, no matter how they have been frowning, they will be glad. Amen. I said they will be glad. Amen. Let me hear your louder amen. Amen. They will be glad. You know how the disciples were living? They were living such a generosity life that a beggar sought them and was expecting something. Remember the beautiful gate? They say, he looked unto them expecting something. And they said, today we are not going to give you offering. Such as we have, give I unto thee. We have the name and the power. In the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. I hear some story today among family, Christian family, and I'm afraid. Where husband will not feed the wife. Excuse me. And you see how Muslims marry for and they take them to Hajj. You, son of Jesus. Son of Jesus. You marry one and you cannot feed him. I sit in church. I'm telling you. We have to correct those errors. We have to correct those abnormalities. There are too many. Somebody cannot give food for his children to eat. They are begging you. What went wrong? That is the highest order of decadence. Are you there? Then said unto them, after they were glad, from today, wherever you speak, you'll be speaking to people who are joyous. Because of your presence. He said, then said Jesus to them again, peace be unto you. As my Father have sent me, even so send I you. Now, we find our bearing and our calling from the bearing of the calling of Jesus. What was he doing? He had an understanding that was a positive influencer. So he went out. He went out. Please, this month, don't sleep until you have touched one life. And we all have the resources. We all have the resources. We all have even a call. You didn't see somebody today? Just call him. How are you? You don't know his state wherever he was. Your call could avert suicide. Your call could make him to wake up tomorrow. Your call. Somebody check on me today. He said, I was just around Yale and I discovered I'm so low. That's a very senior man in terms of wealth sometimes. So I discovered I'm so low. So I just said, let me turn in. When she arrived, I was alerted. He was there. And I came. And by the time he was going, he was jubilating. He was happy. Please, at the mention of your name, let no one depress. Let no one do what? Depress anymore. Be a lifter of souls. Be a lifter of souls. Is somebody hearing me right now? All right. These are the secret that power the thing you want. Are you there? As the Father have sent me, so have I sent you. Now, listen to my statement here. I put it in my note. I say, a discovery of Jesus' purpose on earth gives every believer a picture of their purpose on earth. And we have run through. If you look at John, 1 John, at 1 John chapter 3, verse 8. 1 John chapter 3, verse 8. Add it to the scripture we have read. 1 John chapter 3 and verse 8. It says, he that committed sin is of the devil, for the devil sinned from where? From the beginning. Look at the purpose. For this purpose, the Son of God was made manifest that he might destroy the works of the devil. So Jesus end operation of the devil. That was his nature. Now give us a give us a Message Bible. I want you to see it from Message. Message says, those who make a practice of sin and straight from the devil, the pioneer of the practice of the sin. Look at the next B part. The Son of God enter into the sin to abolish. You are the full stop to evil. I'm not hearing your amen. You are the full stop to what? To evil. You are not a perpetrator of it. You are the one that ended. Everywhere Jesus entered, Christ stopped. He was a positive influencer. And we should take our bearing from him. We should take our bearing from him. You will not be the same. Amen. I say you will not be the same. I need to finish this section today. You will not be the same. Amen. Now look at what he says. I said, believers are born to be a positive influencer of their generation. John chapter 15 and verse 16. John 15, 16. You are God's choice to end tears. You are God's choice. You are God's spiritual handkerchief to wipe tears. He said, you didn't choose me. Remember, I chose you and put you in the wall to bear fruit. Fruit that won't spoil. As fruit bearer whatsoever. Listen to that word. As fruit bearer whatsoever ye ask the Father in relation to me, he gives you. As fruit bearer. So if you are not a fruit bearer, you don't have access to answer prayer. As a fruit bearer, I'm reading a message for you. You didn't choose me. Remember, I choose you and put you in the world to bear fruit. Release what you are made of. I'm the seed inside you. Show the fruit of righteousness. Are you hearing that? And then he said, fruit that won't spoil. As a fruit bearer. That's what this month is calling us to. Go and be a fruit bearer. The world is hungry. Go and give them the fruit of salvation. As a fruit bearer, here is your blessing. Whatsoever ye ask of Father in relation to me, he will do what? He gives you. He gives you. He gives you. I say, we are the seed of God for the fruitfulness of our generation. We are the seed of God for the fruitfulness of our generation. Our impact on our generation is their hope, is the hope of their fulfillment. Our impact, our influences on our generation is the hope of our generation for their fulfillment. If we don't rise and show them what we carry, the seed that we, and give them the fruit of the seed of who made us, they have no hope of fulfillment. You remember that? Romans chapter 8 and verse 19. He said, the earnest creature are waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. The earnest creature are waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. Hallelujah. Matthew chapter 5 and verse 14. As you get ready to take communion, that is the strength that is being revitalized in you. Can I hear your resounding amen? Can I hear your resounding amen? Amen. You need this kind of message to be dead to self. Yes, to be dead to self. As long as you are alive to self, it becomes difficult to impart your surrounding. Become dead to impact your surrounding. Matthew chapter 5 and verse 14. What did he say? Scripture said that what? We are the light of the world. Turn to your neighbor and say, you are the light of the world. Point to someone intentionally. You are the light. God showed me something in the afternoon, which I've never seen it that way. He said, you are the light of the world. A city that is set on hill cannot be hid. That means we are expected to be visibly visible by impact in our area. We are expected to be what? To be visibly visible in everywhere we are located, everywhere we are found. And God taught me something which I want to tell you. God said to me, the darkness we see around, take note, the darkness we see around us, the darkness we see around us points to the fact that the lights of the world have failed. Or it may not be as effective as it's expected. You know, the Bible says we are the light of the world. Is that, how many of you are the light of the world? Because you have to agree with whom God. Let me see your hand. How many of you are the light of the world? Now, the Lord said to me that so the darkness we see around is that it's either we have failed or we are not as effective as we ought to. What are the darkness? Robbers, armed robbery, kidnapping, corruptions. Do you understand what I'm saying? Those are the work of darkness. That means we have stopped illuminating our generation. He say you are the light. We jump at it. What does light do? So darkness. Darkness is dispelled by light. Evil should be far away. So all the evil we are seeing is because our light has dimmed. It has ceased. It has no more effect as it ought to. You know, some bulb in your house, after a while, they started going dimming. And then you start seeing darkness coming. All the evil we are hearing is as a result of lack of credibility to the light. The darkness we see. The darkness we see. I was praying one prayer for myself this hour today. I said, Lord, let me not get to a point that my time is over and the church I pastor cannot bury me. A man of God have died. His community said the church cannot bury him. It is a secret society that will bury him. Yeah. That there is a sect to bury him. Why do you get the power for? You get it to heal people. How come the people can? Why will you get to that level? Why? You know how many Christians that are in Freemason today? If it's God you want to be rich for, you will not do what will make God to be angry. When I die, even my children will be there. That's my prayer. When you can say, but you don't know what pushed them there. And you are not dying now. So all you can do is to pray to God. Lord, let me not follow other God apart from you. You know, when you sit down like this, say, nah, why? Peter did that. But before the call crowed three times, did he not deny Jesus? It's not by power, it's not by might. So you pray, you start praying some prayer. Do you know lack of husband can lead you there? You are watching a man like this. This man is not straight. This is a diabolical man. But he said he proposed. He proposed to take your life to hell. The darkness we see, that's the message I received from God. And I asked me to. The darkness you see around us today is because the light are no longer shining. It's dim. It's no longer effective. It's no longer effective. A man saw me the other day. He said, I know that man will leave your church very shortly. I said, why? He said, I've listened to your message. He cannot stand it. The light, we are getting darker. Do you know? You are saying, What of the money you ask and they gave you an M-Pesa and you change your line? Change your line completely. Or they are calling you, say, that stupid man. And his money is with you. The lights are dimming. The lights are dimming. We need prayer. We need what? Prayer for ourselves, not for anyone. Don't wait till your own be like that of Peter. At which Peter tells Jesus, you mean I can deny you? Please lay hand on me. You will have been that woman. Say, help my unbelief. The lights are darker. The lights are dimmer. That is why the whole world is engrossed with darkness. And you know what? That's a prophecy in Isaiah chapter 60. He said what? Arise and shine. For thy light has come, and the glory of the Lord will be risen upon you. For gross darkness shall come upon the earth, and the people shall be gross. People shall be gross. So we need to pray. We need to pray. How many believers today can you forget money and they say they see it? We need prayer. The corruption, the evil we see in the land is as a result of the dimming of the light. And the Bible says, you and I, we are the light of the world. We've stopped making impact on our neighbor. We've stopped what? Making impact on our neighbor. Our neighbor stopped seeing direction from us. So we need to pray. We need to pray as we reach out to touch them. I see a new you. I say, I see a new you in the name of Jesus Christ. I see a new you. I want to hear your amen. I say, the darkness we see around us points to the fact that the light of the world has failed, or it may not be effective as it ought to be. Jesus had an understanding that our generation didn't have. So he never waited for him to be invited. He went about doing good, healing all that were oppressed of the devil. Everywhere Jesus went, he never waited for invitation. He never. He kept on impacting his generation. As you live here, receive the same baptism. I say, receive the same baptism. Receive the same baptism. You get to your family circle, you travel home, ask about other people's children. Since the father respects you by your voice, he may take back those children to school. Look for how you can impact people. Praise God. I said, praise God. The mama was telling me about somebody's house in Nigeria. How many people did they say I was going to university? Bishop Abiodun's house. About 40. That somebody say, that is the one he knows. And you know he doesn't know his hometown. 40 children to university. Now you have slice of bread to give to your neighbor. You refuse. 40 people, and I'm a witness, because I knew when it was, all those dupe and all. Over 40 people have gone to university in his house. No wonder people were flowing in for his son's wedding, all over. If nobody respects you, ask yourself a question. Respect is earned. You know why you say, shall we pray in your family? And everybody open their eyes. They know at the end of your prayer, nothing will come out. They are tired. You know, you normally have an aid behind scripture. They have told you problems. Say, shall we pray? Our everlasting Father. And you quote 50 scriptures. No 10 shillings drop. And it's just void here. You could put, I don't have much for this issue, but I have 300 that remain in my pocket. Here is it. Somebody say, how will I get back? Get to the main road. You will get back. What to make happen for someone, God will ensure it multiply back to you. Can I hear your louder amen? Amen. Can I hear your louder amen? Amen. This self-centered Christianity has robbed us a life of the miraculous. Self-centered Christianity. I, my wife, my children. Let's go and impact our surrounding. The communion today brings you to a new fellowship. Can I hear your louder amen? Can I hear your louder amen? Bring you to a new fellowship. A new fellowship. When we're going to do introduction, please go ahead. When we're going to do introduction to Mama, I'm going to their place, and he's also knowing my place for the first time. We're at park, and I was waiting. I don't know how you do your own park here, Nigeria garage, until the car or the bus on stage until it's full. The next one cannot load. You see the same thing here? So human beings are the same. So we were waiting and waiting and waiting. So I asked the driver, why are we not going? They say, we are not complete. How many do you carry? He told me, I count them. I said, excuse me, who is the counter? And you know how I can be loud. Who is the counter? Does he know? Does he went to school at all? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? They say, no, that small boy has no transport. He has no transport. That's why we have been waiting for almost 1 hour. I turned to Mama. Do you have the money there? How much? They say he has 50 shillings. He need to add to him. Now, meanwhile, our own money is not enough. Self will not let you impart. Do you know every day you have a dream? And for you to help somebody, you have to minus your dream. And let go. It's always like that. So I told Mama, give the boy. Let's go. And I asked the driver, why are you so wicked? This small boy? He said, no, I bought my petrol. You know, they have mouth. I gave him the money. And we left. The money in her hand is not enough. We got to my hometown, and you know, old woman, when we go to introduce, and she was looking very beautiful. They believe she has money. They were coming and greeting and greeting. And Mama asked me, what do I do with those old women? I said, give them money. I said, from where? I said, from what remain? So when we are leaving my people's house, we are like zero. And we are to travel over, like from here to Isibani. So let's go. From my home to where we are, to the next state, Isibani there, it was favor upon favor. We pay not a shilling. One of the trip for tomorrow, going to our place, the man gave us money. I got to somewhere, it looked like we are stranded, and other people pick us. And actually bought me what I took to my in-laws to be a good man. A whole basket of Irish potato. The man said, we are buying, want to buy, pastor? Pastor doesn't have money. Say no, we get you one crate. Load it in their car. If God cover you, nobody will see your nakedness. Even if they lift up your clothes, they will see it. The Lord will cover you. I lift up your two hands. As you are partaking of this communion, I release you as an agent to affect your immediate environment, Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and unto the uttermost part of the earth. From today, your nakedness will not be seen. Before your shame arrives, the supply of heaven is waiting. As you put smile on people's faces, God will begin to put smile on your faces. As you weigh in somebody's confess, your children will never be sent out of school. In the name of Jesus Christ, this blessing will flow to your life
and to a generation to come. In the mighty name of Jesus. As we partake of this communion, we receive this grace by impartation. At the communion table, life is imparted. That self-centeredness, the blood you are taking today, somebody laid down his life. I decree that from now, you will lay down your life. The power to lay down your life, receive it via this communion. He took the drink and blessed it and said, this is my body, blood shed for you. By the impartation of today's communion, self-centeredness, die. Self-centered, die. When you see the needy, your eyes will no longer be closed. In the name of Jesus Christ. And he took the body and blessed it also. I prepare your new life to be a distributor. A liberal soul shall be made fat. I decree by today's communion, as you take today's communion, you enter into a new season. The forces of heaven will now guarantee your supply at all time and in all situations. The communion is blessed in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' precious name, amen. Please, the steward, go ahead.
There is healing in the blood. Healing in the blood. There is healing in the blood of Jesus. There is healing in the blood, healing. Oh, there is healing in the blood of Jesus. There is power.
There is power in the blood.
Power in the blood.
Power in the blood.
There is power in the blood
of Jesus.
Healing. There is healing in the blood. Healing the blood.
Healing in the blood.
You see, there is healing. Strength, there is strength in the blood. Strength in the blood. You see, there is strength in the blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
There is power in the blood.
Power in the blood.
There is power. Blood,
the blood of Jesus.
Healing, there is healing in the blood.
Healing the blood.
You see, there is healing in the blood of Jesus. There is power in the blood.
Power in the blood.
There is power in the blood
of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you. Let this blood flow right now in our spiritual vein and give us the power to lay down. Jesus, you say you have the power to lay down and the power to take it again. It takes spiritual power not to close our eyes to the needy, not to be self-centered, to lay down for order to enjoy. And for as many that have been doing this, I decree a fresh door for you. Say louder, amen. A door of favor. A door of uncommon favor. Unlimited favor. Great and effectual door. The era of self-centeredness hereby crushed in our life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let's put our hands together for this powerful service. So enriching, so instructive. Amen. Bring out your offering. Giving is living. When you stop giving, you start dying. That's why God made it so generous.
that everyone has what to give. Everyone has what? What to give. And one thing I've learned about giving, it has to be planned. You have to plan and be determined. Farmer plan and they are determined. They keep their seed no matter the hunger, because they know they have no place in the future harvest without the seed on the earth. Package your offering. And also God went for that and said, let every man give as he's able. Never you doing justice to yourself by giving lower than where you belong. Praise God. And you know what? You are the one who know how God has blessed you. God never looked at what we hold in our hands. He looked at what remained behind. Praise God. Lift up that offering with that charge. If you are paying your tithe, please jump to the front. Father Lord, open your mouth and thank him. I want you to pray over your offering. I'm not hearing your prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you for the opportunity to worship you, to complete my worship of you with my substance. I appreciate you. I glorify you, Lord. Lord, take me to another level. Multiply the seed that I'm sowing today. And Lord, keep me out of every form of affliction. You say you will lay our bed in affliction. Lord, keep me out of the reach of any kind of affliction. Thank you, faithful Father. Multiply our seed in Jesus' precious name. For those of you who are paying your tithe, may the heaven over you remain open. May the Lord prosper you on every side. In the name of Jesus Christ, please cast your offering. Listen to the following announcement. Empowering Your Weak Voice of Restoration Morning Glory live streaming service we hold tomorrow. And we are still looking at what to do when Pharaoh is too close to you. Praise the Lord. The time is 5:45. Endeavor to join East African time. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. Starting point to breakthrough classes we hold on Saturday at 1 and also after our Sunday service. Don't forget, hymn books are still on offer. Get your own copy and get blessed. Praise the Lord. You can, in case your sticker, I see some sticker, they are very old now. You can renew for just 30 shillings. Praise the Lord. You can renew, you can get a new one. I think your own is old. Eh? The way you say this hallelujah is phenomenal. You can go to bookshop and pick there for 30 shillings and renew the one on your door everywhere and make the remaining half of the year new in your life. Praise the Lord. Don't forget, this coming Sunday is a special Sunday. It's our covenant day of healing. Covenant day of healing. Covenant day of healing. You may not be sick, but help us invite the sick. God is still healing his people. Praise the Lord. Invite anyone that you know is sick. Pay their transport. Help them to get their healing. And God will be mighty in our midst, disarming all form of sickness. In Jesus' precious name. Tell your neighbor, you may not be sick, but in case you know anyone, apart from standing in the gap, you can also invite them to be here practically. Amen. Praise God. Let's rise up on our feet and say after me, Father, I pray at the beginning of this service that let this service impart me with a new attitude. I live here today conscious of my purpose and conscious of the ability I have to change my environment. I am a new light to chase away the darkness of my day. I receive grace to do this effectively. Amen. Let's share the goodness. Surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the presence of the Lord forever and ever. The Lord God is my son and my shield. He will give us. No good thing will he withhold from us as we walk uprightly. We are restored to power, to dominion, to honor, and to dignity. Amen. It is my year of a crowning restoration. I am pursuing the troop. I have overtaken them already. Without failing, I'm recovering all. Amen. Be blessed. Make sure you share your joy with someone. Give them your hand, imparting them with the grace that you carry, and be blessed of the Lord. Don't walk away like that. Make sure you greet someone. Look for someone and greet. That's what we say. Impact your surrounding with the joy of the Lord.
You are marvelous. You are marvelous. You are marvelous.